Hello, everybody. Welcome to Managerial Accounting. This is my overview and a discussion of managerial accounting versus financial accounting. So as I was going through and I'm starting to make videos in a managerial accounting series, I want to, before I get into or before I make more videos, I wanted to kind of take a step back and look to see, well, really, what's the difference and why do so many students struggle with managerial accounting? Some students really excel at it, but there's a lot of students that really struggle. And let's kind of go through this. Financial accounting is really nicely wrapped up. You start by recording transactions. We're going to prepare those financial statements, an income statement, a statement of retained earnings, and a balance sheet. And then we're going to take a trip down the balance sheet. We're going to look at inventory, cash, receivables, property, plant, and equipment, not personal protective equipment, non-current assets, current liabilities, non-current liabilities, not James Bond, but bonds and owner's equity. A final exam is generally going to be a statement of cash flows, and it really ties everything nicely together. And remember that financial accounting, usually you take it over one semester as a lower division student. But this is the class that turns into a year of intermediate accounting. So financial, if you're going on in accounting and you're struggling with managerial, it's okay. Managerial accounting, very, very different than financial accounting. But financial accounting becomes intermediate, which was one of the most more important parts of accounting. So with managerial accounting, it's a little bit different and it's kind of like a little bit more convoluted, but as you kind of look at it, it's really there kind of there. It's really there to give you as a future business person, a solid foundation for what you're seeing in business, because although financial accounting ties up everything together, financial accounting deals with the past, right? What we're more interested in is the future. I sound like cable. So right over here, right? We know what that reference is. Maybe, I don't know. So we have here financial statement analysis. This is sometimes taught in financial accounting, which is absolutely insane. Financial statement analysis is extremely difficult to teach on an exam. My students do not do well. And if I have time, what I try to go through and do is have them do a paper instead. But again, it's a very, very challenging thing because you have to go through and perform certain steps. There's not an absolutely right answer. There's going to be a better reasoned answer. Next part of managerial accounting is determining how does inventory work for a manufacturer. Right? We're going to, first step is going through and generally determining what is cost of goods manufactured. And then we're going through and looking at job order costing, process costing, and then different overhead methodologies. The next topic that's typically taught is cost, volume, profit, and absorption costing. In this one, we are really separating our fixed costs and our variable costs. We're trying to figure out how do we break even? How does financial accounting through absorption costing potentially distort information? We're also going to be looking at cash budgeting. This is not the statement of cash flows, but this is future cash budgeting. When you start working in business, cash budgeting is so important. Cannot tell you, first day as an assistant controller, when you walk into that office, you have to know how your money is coming in. Without money, we cannot pay the bills. Without paying the bills, we're going to go bankrupt. We don't want to have that happen to us. Standard costing, what this is really going to teach us about is that as we're putting direct materials, direct labor, and overhead into production, if for some reason costs start going way up, we need to know so we can make adjustments to things potentially like pricing. We're also going to be going through and looking at departmental budgeting, different ways of going through and making allocations. Typically also managerial accounting, you're going to find a chapter that goes through business decisions, make or buy. Should we sell or process further, scrap and rework? All those different kinds of fun things. Now, over here, we've got net present value. This is kind of an extension of what you learned in bonds if you used present value tables. There's also different types of other kind of off topics, which are pricing, balance scorecard, responsibility accounting. So those will be some topics that I'll go through and explore a little bit later. Generally, when I go through and teach managerial accounting, I'll sometimes touch on those subjects, but a little bit in a different way. Now, the keys to your success in managerial accounting, you have to use T accounts for cost of goods manufactured, job order costing, and process costing. I have spoken with upper division accounting instructors that teach cost accounting. If you don't know how to use the T accounts, you are not going to be in good shape. You've got to use T accounts. And you'll see as I'm going through and making these videos why the T accounts are so important for this segment. You're going to be able to kind of go through and see how that process flow goes through. So if you're not good with T accounts, go ahead and check out some of my other videos, especially the introduction to the accounting. That should help you practice and get really good for this part. The other part is you want to take a step back and kind of try to look at the information. You're going to be kind of lost in the weeds sometimes. Take a step back. Does this make sense in terms of what I'm going through and doing? What are we trying to accomplish? Also, too, when you will oftentimes in managerial accounting be asked to give an analysis, right? Don't just say, yes, I would agree, or no, that's not a good idea. No, you've got to quantify your analysis, right? If we say that, oh, I chose to look at this number, why? Because it's material. As a percentage of total assets, inventory is a really big number. Now, the most important thing to do, and this is really where accounting is incredibly deceiving. Like, I can come out here and make videos all day and say, oh, yes, Tchaikovsky, I understand. This is great. No, you've got to take a pencil and pen and practice. Accounting is a skill. It requires practice and repetition. This is why accounting jobs pay so well, because it is a skill and you have to go through and practice. Now, when you take the CPA exam, if that's what your ultimate goal is going to be, you will have a version of Microsoft Excel that you can actually use on the CPA exam. However, as you're first learning accounting, I generally do not recommend that you go through and do that. I think you're going to be much better off by practicing. Also, too, over here, for example, for any types of visualizations, you will see me use not only T accounts, you'll see me use other types of charts. Just it's really, you want to kind of visualize what you're doing. Don't just go through and memorize things, have a visualization. So when you get to the exam, develop those tools so you know what to go through and do. And by the way, what you are learning here is extremely important for the future, especially something like net present value. I was speaking with an MBA instructor and he said, well, I've got a bunch of students that don't know how to do net present value. And that's what always is my greatest fear as an accounting instructor, is that when you go to the next level, and you took my class and you're expected to know something you don't. So that's really one of those things where net present value is one of those such hugely important concepts, as well as cash budgeting, future cash budgeting. Those are really the things you want to kind of go through and take away with. There are some students who do much better in managerial accounting. This is because their mind works like a little bit more analytically, right? So if a student struggled in financial, they can actually do really well in managerial. But the key to accounting is practice, right? I'm using the words of Roger Phillip, who runs UWorld Rogers CPA Review. He was actually my live CPA review instructor back in 1991, right? Roger is amazing, right? And when you look at, you know, how you practice and how you get ready for accounting exams, it's by practice. That is how you learn. Even if you can use Excel, don't do it, right? Practice by physically writing it out. I have seen differences between students who use AutoPen and the students who physically write it out. And the reason is, if you're taking an exam that requires you to handwrite out everything, you better be handwriting out everything. Even if it doesn't, I would still go through and do it, because the physically writing out, don't mean to kill trees, but we're doing it for a good reason. It's because if you don't practice, it's not going to sink in. So again, that's at least for myself and how many of my other students learn, is by practice. So I want to thank you for joining me here today. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them below. Appreciate you liking and subscribing to the channel. And if there's any other videos that I can make for you, please feel free to reach out. Have a great day.